Hi, we're Linda and Lisa, and we're a pair. With these dice, we're on the air with On a Roll!
Thank you very, very much, everybody. Welcome to On a Roll. I am absolutely thrilled to be here, and do I have a surprise for you. I'm going to turn around here and introduce you to people that you have seen in television commercials, and you probably chew their gum. They are Linda and Lisa, the Doublemint Twins. And I gotta tell you, your eyes aren't fooling you. They are absolutely gloriously beautiful and two lovely people as well. And I'm very pleased to have you working with me. Ladies, if you would take your positions,
certainly.
We will introduce today's rollers. Sharon and Tim. Welcome to the show, both of you.
Thank you.
Sharon McMurtry, you have something interesting to tell us.
Well, first of all, I am a flight attendant for a major airline. I'm married, I have a 3-year-old little boy, and I have another one on the way.
The story isn't true. Would you step out here? The fact that she is pregnant clearly does not mean that she is heavy with child.
Nope.
You look absolutely astonishingly beautiful yourself.
Thank
and
you.
Welcome to the show.
Thank you.
You bet. And we have Tim Butler, who has this to say about himself.
Well, I'm a reservation agent for a major airline, and I love game shows and ready to win some money.
Is your major airline the same as her major airline?
We are
competitors.
Direct competitors.
Direct competitors. Okay, both in your jobs and on the set.
That's exactly.
So I am going to wish you both the very best of luck and ask you, are you as excited to get going as I am?
Very much
you bet.
So.
With that, let us proceed. And I will tell you a few things. First of all, to play On a Roll, you need to capture these dice by winning the name game. Now, we're going to show you a famous name, and we'll reveal it backwards to you, one letter at a time. The first player to recognize the name gets 4 rolls of the dice, and we are going to start with the last letter. Go. N. O. T. G. Tim.
Washington.
Yes.
Washington it is. Washington it is. And of course, Sharon says that she knew it, and if it hadn't been you to get it, she would have been right there. You have just now gotten 4 rolls of the dice that you are in control of. Tim, if you'll step over here, I will show you how the dice do their work. Take a look at our puzzle board. There are 3 separate clues, a top, a middle, and a bottom, all of which add up to 1 single answer. Now, you are going to use the numbers that you roll with the dice in order to uncover the clues, except for those that are blocked. Incidentally, as Linda is pointing out, they are the ones with question marks in front of them. Those can never be revealed. One word of warning, my friend. As you roll these dice, do not get doubles, because should you, your opponent, Sharon, gets 1 free letter and immediately takes over control of the dice.
No.
The legal work is done. You understand the rules. I am going to turn the dice over to you with the following admonishment. Good luck. And my friend, you are on a roll.
Okay. Anything but doubles. Come on.
And a 1 and a 3, or you can combine them, Tim, and take a 4.
Let me have a 1 on the top and a 3 on the top, please.
Starting right at the beginning, you have an S and an O. Do you want to guess at the clue?
Not yet.
All right. You have 3 rolls left.
Okay. Let's get a 4 and a 5. 4 and a 5.
Doubles.
Doubles. Doubles. You're right, you are competitors. My goodness. I'm sorry, Tim, you know, but that's how things roll around here. I'm awfully sorry that you got doubles, but Sharon, this provides you with an opportunity. You, first of all, inherit 2 rolls of the dice, and for the moment, you also get to take any free letter that you would like.
I will take number 4, please, on the top.
And it is an N. Would you like to guess at the clue?
No, not right this minute, thanks.
All right, then you have 2 rolls left, as we just said.
Thank you. Come on, 5.
You've got a 4 and a 5,
okay.
Or a 9.
I will take the 5 on the top, please. And I guess the 4 on the bottom. Thanks.
All right. Now, let me point out that you can guess at either the top clue or the bottom.
I don't have a guess. I'm sorry.
All right. You do have one more roll, meaning that that is your last roll. And I'm going to wish you a lot of luck.
Thank you.
Because you got to make this one
count.
Thank you. All right.
I guess anything that'll give me a clue.
And you have a 2 and a 5 or a 7.
I would like the 2 and the 5 on the bottom, please.
An O and an H.
Gosh, I don't know. I'm sorry.
No guess?
No.
Okay, well, you are out of roll, Sharon. We'll ask you to step back behind the podium here. The dice are up for grabs. Your turn, sir, to get back into it. It is back to the name game, and let us start revealing it backwards. Go. I. T. T. O. R. A. Tim.
Pavarotti.
The way you said Pavarotti sounds like Brooklynese for Pavarotti. It's Luciano Pavarotti, the great tenor, right? Anyway, step into the box, my friend. You are now in control of the dice for 4 rolls, and we are back with the same puzzle. So go ahead and give it your best shot.
Okay, let's get a 6, 7, or an 8.
A 1 and a 6 or a 7.
I would like a 1 on the bottom and a 6 on the bottom, please.
A T. And a B. Do you have any guess at the clue?
Torch burner.
Very good.
Well, by way of introduction, that's the first time you've heard that little sound effect, but you know from hearing it that
probably
means...
Hear it again.
No, I'm sorry, it is not torch burner. You have 3 rolls left.
Okay.
Come on, double.
Yeah. All right, come on.
Give
let's
it the best shot you can.
7 or 8.
A 2 and a 4 or a 6.
I'd like 6 on the top, please.
And there is no 4 anywhere on the board, so that is all you've got. Do you want to take a guess at that?
Yes. On the top, Stoneface.
Stoneface, yes. Very good. Okay. Stone-faced, he said with a grin. Now, you got that clue, stone-faced, and you know that you are now entitled to 1 guess at the entire puzzle.
Is it the thinker?
Is it the thinker for the game? Gosh, I'm sorry. I'm very sorry. The Thinker by Rodin, I think, was the statue. No, it isn't. But you do have 2 rolls left, Tim.
Okay.
So go ahead. I urge
All
you
right.
To make a
Come
count.
On. 7 or an 8.
Double,
7
double,
or an 8.
And you got a 3 and a 6 or a 9.
Let me take a 9 on the bottom, please, David.
All right, Tim, you have an R there. Do you want to guess at the clue?
Not yet.
Down to your last roll.
Okay.
Down to your last roll. So,
let's go for our lucky 7 on this one.
Yeah, all right.
Lucky 7. Come on, where are you? We haven't had you yet.
You have a 1 and a 2 or a 3.
Well, let's take the 1 and the 2 in the middle row.
That might provide an interesting clue for you. N, E. You want to guess at the clue?
Nope.
All right. Step out of the box and back behind the podium because, as you know, we are out of rolls.
Oh, I know.
And that's all right. Sharon, the dice are up for grabs again. It's back to the name game, and let's start revealing it to you people backwards. And go. It's a D. A Y. An O. An R. A K. Boy, that was close. Tim?
I was going to say Aykroyd.
Yes!
Yes. Brought your own cheering section right here. Okay, step back into the box. You have 4 rolls right now, and Lisa will pass you the dice.
Okay, thanks, Lisa. All right, I want a 7 or an 8, please.
You got a 1 and a 2 or a 3.
Let me take the 3 on the middle, please.
All right, do you want to guess at the clue?
New Yorker.
Very good. And if I may be allowed to make an editorial comment, this is a very interesting puzzle. Stone-faced New Yorker. What does that add up to? Now, you know that because you got the clue, New Yorker, you can take a guess at the puzzle.
Is it the Statue of Liberty?
For the game, is it the Statue of Liberty?
Yeah!
And the torch burner you were looking for turned out to be torch bearing as the third clue. That's very good. And you win game number one. And Sharon, plenty of time for you to catch up because we're going to be right back with another game after this brief timeout.
Alex Trebek before Jeopardy.
Those are the spoilers. We can boo them if we want.
Double Dare, tomorrow at 8 on Buzzer, Lost and Found. Be there for Ray Combs' first hour-long Family Feud.
Thank you so very much. Thank you for tuning in at home.
Up next on Buzzer, Lost and Found.
We are back with Sharon and Tim, and Tim has just won game one. It's not all that important because you've got some time to catch up, Sharon. Remember, two games wins the match and $1,000 and a chance to play Lucky 7 for the big money. Let us start our second game. Take a look at our new puzzle. And obviously, in order to get into that, we are going to throw the dice up in the air again. It's back to the name game. Let's start revealing it backwards. And go. D. O. O. W.
Yes, Sharon.
Don't have it? Okay, a little too early. You goofed. That means you get one free letter over there, Tim. It's a T and a guess.
Eastwood.
Yes. Eastwood. Eastwood. Plenty of time. Doesn't mean a thing, as they say in sports. Come on in here, Tim. You got four rolls, and again, we have a brand new puzzle to work with. Lisa will hand you the dice. And we wish you the best of luck.
Okay.
All right.
Anything but double. Double.
A one and a four or a five.
I would like a one on the bottom and a four on the bottom, please.
An N and an E. Would you like to guess at the clue?
Nose of...
Okay, you're out of time. Three rolls left, Tim.
Okay, let's have a seven or an eight. Seven or an eight.
A one and a four or a five?
Let me try a five on the bottom, please.
Three-word clue. You want to take a guess at it?
Not yet.
Okay, two rolls left.
Come on, double.
Come on, seven, eight, or nine. Double. Seven, eight, or nine. Seven, eight, or nine. Seven, eight, or nine.
You got your seven, a one and a six or a seven?
I would like a seven on the bottom, please.
And it is an F. Take a guess.
Nice to feel.
I'm not even going to comment on that. Okay. You have one roll left. This is your last one again.
Okay.
So you 2, 6, 8, 9, 10. If you want to work on the bottom clue, it would be great.
Yeah, let's try for an 8 or a 9. 8, 9, or 10. Either one's okay.
And
a 10.
You have a 4 and a 6, or you got your 10. Very good.
Let's take a 10 on the bottom, please, Tim.
And it is an E, Tim.
Nice to face.
Again, that buzzer. And again, that means no, you are out of rolls. The dice once again are up for grabs. Sharon, your chance. It's back to the name game. Let's start revealing it backwards. And go. E. N. I. N. G. Sharon.
Borgnine.
Yes. Borgnine. Fan of McHale's Navy, perhaps?
Of course.
Of course. All right. You got four rolls of the dice, and the situation is pretty much wide open. So give it your best shot.
Okay, thanks a lot. Just about anything.
And you got a one and a four or a five?
Let's take a four on the top, please.
And the one has to come from
the middle. I'm sorry, one. Yeah, I'm sorry.
One from the middle.
I had one.
Okay, now you can guess at either the top or the middle clue.
I'm sorry. No guess.
Okay. Plenty of time yet. You got three rolls.
Okay. Come on, baby.
And you have a three and a four or a seven.
Let me try the seven on the top, please.
It's a V. Would you like to guess at the clue?
No.
don't have to be sorry. Go ahead and give him a good shake.
Come on, baby. Is there anything that will help?
Doubles. Sorry, kids. You did your best. Plenty of time still. Tim, step back in. Oh. You are going to inherit one roll of her dice as well as one free letter.
Let me have the 8 on the bottom, please.
And it's an I. Do you want to guess that clue?
9 to 5 on the bottom.
Yes. It's 9 to 5. Very, very good. All right. Now, you got that clue correct. You can now guess at the entire puzzle.
Is it Dolly Parton?
For the match and $1,000, is it Dolly Parton? Yeah. It is Dolly Parton. It is Dolly Parton. Nice work, Tim. All it took you was one brief clue, and you are on to greater heights. Sharon, I am awfully sorry to have to say goodbye to you. It has been very pleasant meeting you, number one. I wish you the very best of luck in your continuing your work and in your pregnancy.
Thank you very much.
Honestly. And you're not going to go away empty-handed. We do have some nice parting gifts for you. So good luck and have a safe ride.
Thank you.
All right? Okay. Now, just to take a quick look at the other clues here. We had Top Heavy and Country Girl. You didn't need that to come up with Dolly Parton. Very good, Tim. All right, now look, step into the box for me. This is the big moment, my friend, because we're going to find out how much you're going to play for in Lucky 7. We're going to give you one roll of these dice, and whatever you roll, we will multiply by $1,000. So let's take a 5, for example. You roll a 5, you're going to be playing for $5,000.
Well, I'm going to roll
Here are the
12.
Dice. Good luck to you.
Come on, right. Double sixes! Double sixes!
And it's a 7. Okay. So, when we return, Tim will be playing for $7,000. Very good. Nice.
It's black and white and fun all over again.
Good night, Mrs. Calabash, wherever you are.
Sunday nights at 8, only on Buzzer. Let's play.
We are back with Tim Butler, who has just managed to win the game and $1,000, so you already have that to your credit. But now is an opportunity to win $7,000, Tim, in Lucky 7. And if you will take a look up at our board, I will explain how we play this portion of our game. There are 7 words or phrases up there, all covered up. And what we are going to do for you is reveal them to you letter by letter backwards. You've heard that before. As soon as you recognize one of the words or phrases, shout it out. And the reason that I say that is you're going to be playing against a clock which is set to 60 seconds. Now, here's a hint for you. Every one of these 7 words or phrases has something to do with the subject underwater. All right? You understand that? Now, for every one you get correct, we will give you $100. If you get all 7 in 60 seconds or less, we're going to give you $7,000. You got that all down?
That's good.
So, remember, the clue is underwater. And timekeeper, if we can have the clock set for 60 seconds. Take a deep breath. I am really hoping for you, my friend. Okay? Good luck. And last letter, now. E-N-I-R. A.
Submarine.
Right. Next. D. I. A.
Mermaid.
Right. Next. R. E.
Davy's Locker.
V. I.
Skin diver. Scuba diver.
D. Right. Next. F.
Coral reef.
Right. Next. S. U. P.
Oh, octopus.
Right. Next. C. I. N. A.
Titanic.
Right. Next. D. E. E.
Seaweed.
Right. Good. 16 seconds left. That is just tremendous. Absolutely tremendous. And listen to them out there. They're going crazy for you, Tim. All right. You just won yourself $7,000. There are $1,000 for the game. $8,000. We'll be right back. That's just tremendous.
Up next, it's a very special glimpse at a rare one-hour Family Feud experiment. Then, see how the experiment worked with more Family Feud next. Stay tuned.
awful lot of excitement around here. Tim Butler, the reservations agent, just won himself $8,000, and I sense that you are going to make a reservation for yourself and go off to Hawaii or something of that nature. More importantly, Tim, you are going to have a chance to come back next time and do it all over again. Maybe win yourself another 8, 10, 12 grand, who knows? But it has been a pleasure having you on this show. Say goodbye to Linda and Lisa. And if you can figure out which is which, you're a better man than me. And we will see you next time with Honor Roll. Thank you, everybody.
This is Gene Woods speaking for Honor Roll, a Mark Goodson television production.